We've made it to Queensland's capital city, which is Brisbane.
And this is our sixth?
Yeah, I think it's our sixth
capital city now around the lap. And I just can't believe we're here. I felt when we started the lap that it was ages away and we're here. I'm so excited.
Yeah, now it's like, oh, well, there's only one, maybe Perth as left? Well. So it's like two capital cities left, potentially. It's pretty surreal.
So last time you guys saw us, we had just left the Gold Coast, and although it didn't quite go to plan, we really loved our time in the Gold Coast. And now we're heading north to the Sunshine Coast, and we thought as we make our way there, we're gonna stop off in the city this morning and check out what Brisbane is all about.
Brisbane's already off to a good start. Accessibility into the city, like driving in, was actually pretty easy. And we're pretty sure we found free parking at the
New Farm Park.
Yeah, there's
so in the park and then on the road beside it. Seems like it's free, unrestricted parking.
Yeah, but there's no signs whatsoever, so hopefully we're right.
Fingers crossed, I mean, come back to it.
If it is and we don't get a ticket, that's pretty good.
I made Vian stop because can someone tell us what these are? They kind of look like sweet potatoes, right? Like the shape of them, but the color's not it. A coconut. It does not look like a coconut. Rock melon.
Rock melon, sweet potato.
Yeah, the colouring's like a normal potato / rock melon, and then the shape is like a sweet potato. If anyone knows what these are, tell us. Fionn's getting shots of it. But we decided we're going to walk into the city, or closer to the city, via the New Farm River Walk. And this is really cool. They've got this like pedestrian bridge that juts out over the river, and it gives really cool perspective of the city. And I felt driving through, we didn't get a good look at the city.
Yeah.
They seem to split this walk into bikes only and pedestrians only, which is actually pretty good. Make sure we stay out of people's way.
There must be some, I don't know, like witchcraft going on, because last couple of weeks / months, I feel like it's been raining like crazy on the East Coast. And every time we looked at the like cloud rain radar thing, it seems like Brisbane and like the Sunshine Coast, just like, it's almost like a magnet. It like pushes the clouds away, because right south of it, it will get absolutely drenched. And then it's just like no rain whatsoever. And I mean,
beautiful sunny day.
I genuinely do not see
a single cloud.
In the sun.
Which is amazing. Because this morning was foggy when we drove in.
Yeah, and it's just like nothing.
But Brisbane apparently is the sunniest capital in Australia. And I think it gets an average of 285 sunny days a year. So apparently there's 15 bridges that cross the Brisbane River, but the most well known is the one that we have the perfect view of right now, which is Story Bridge. And I have seen quite a lot of photos of this. Every time you search up Brisbane, I feel like it is this exact shot.
Another little fun fact, apparently it's Australia's largest cantilevered bridge.
Longest.
Did I say largest?
Yeah.
I mean, I guess it could be wider. But, I mean, same.
I think I read that we drove over it to get here.
Yeah.
And I think I read that over 100,000 people drive across it each day.
It's very reminiscent of the Sydney Opera Bridge, Sydney Harbour Bridge. And I think it's probably just because of the steel members that they used. It looks very much the same color and almost the same, I don't know, like structure, lattice, whatever you want to call it.
So just like we said with Sydney, I feel like ferries are a really cool way to see the city. And thankfully Brisbane actually has a free city hopper ferry that jumps across some of the wharves within the city. So we've hopped on one of those and we're gonna head to something.
It's a little confusing because in Perth they call the free buses cats, and the paid ferry is called the City Cat, and then the free ferry is called the Kitty Cat. But the Kitty Cat is a lot smaller than the City Cat, so it kind of makes sense in that regard, where it's like, oh, Kitty Cat and City Cat is very cute.
The Kitty Cat is very, very cute.
Yeah, it's like short, stumpy, and like narrow. But it's actually pretty quiet, and I would say it's probably similar smoothness and quietness of the more modern ferries in Sydney. Besides having the cool name, I feel like a lot of the ferries that we've seen so far for all the cities have one-upped Perth. I vaguely remember when we went on the Perth ferry back in the days, obviously not on our travels, it was all enclosed, and every single ferry we've been on has had an outdoor area where you can really see, I don't know, like the river, the city.
Feel the breeze.
You can feel the breeze, like get more of a feel.
It's really nice.
So, I mean, Perth, get with the times.
We'll go back now and they'll have like these fully decked out.
It'll be like fully electric, hovering.
It has been like 2 years since we've been back to Perth, so
yeah.
Maybe.
I mean, why would you replace it if it's not broken? So maybe they
so that people like you don't whinge about it. Well, the ferry ended up going the other direction first, so I felt like we were on there for about an hour.
For a long time.
A very long time. But a very beautiful, scenic ferry ride, so no complaints from us. It's just very hot now. But we've hopped off at South Bank. We're gonna check it out.
You going for a swim, are ya?
I want to check the temperature. So Brisbane has this, we're in South Bank, I think we said that, but it has this man-made pool and it even has a beachy area with sand that you can walk into.
Yeah.
And this is so cool. It's free to use and it looks really nice.
It feels like we're at a resort.
I feel like as we go further north in Queensland, especially as we get into croc country, I feel like we're going to see more and more of these types of pools in cities and towns and everything.
Mm.
But it's really cool. This is awesome. I wish we wore bathers, but I want to check the time. It's cool, like cold, but I think refreshing cold.
Yeah.
Because it's hot today.
It is hot.
Nice. You want to feel my hand?
Nah, I'm good.
I feel how wet it is. Tropical resort vibes with the city views.
And the fake trees that we saw at...
Fake pineapple.
Yeah, they look like pineapples from afar, but then when you look closer, you're like, is that a flower? Is that a seed? I don't know.
So apparently Brisbane's sister city is Taiwan, which is interesting because I think Melbourne was a location in a small town in Japan, and
Hobart,
so was Adelaide.
And Hobart.
I think all three of them had a sister city in Japan, but Brisbane's Taiwan.
I think they also have
Taiwan.
Sister cities of other cities, though. I don't know.
What, multiple sister city relationships?
Potentially.
I don't think so. It's just
I might
one.
Be wrong.
Bian's having an I told you so moment.
I am.
So apparently Brisbane also has a sister city relationship in Korea.
In the same garden. They're like, oh, let's just put it all
together. This is
literally together.
Like 20 meters away from the other one. I love how we're walking along the riverbed and it's suddenly turned into like a rainforest area behind us. Yeah, it's so nice and shady, but it's just suddenly like a tropical rainforest walk beside us.
So we were just minding our own business, walking along the South Bank, and we stumbled across this, which is apparently one of three peace pagodas.
Yeah.
Yes, peace pagodas outside of Nepal in the world. And it's very cool. Very beautiful, and
just everything about it is so intricate and so detailed.
And this one is a replica of one in Nepal, I believe. So that's
like, look,
that's
at
pretty
this,
wild
this
to think
column.
That this is, yeah.
Look how much detail is just in this column, and that is like all over the roof, all above us, all throughout the building. It's crazy.
Yeah. And the one in Nepal is hand carved. I'm not sure if this one is. It probably is, if it was done in 1988. It's just crazy to think how long this would have taken to make. And it's pretty cool that it's just here on the South Bank. It's kind of like tucked away in its own little peaceful, quiet, surrounded in like vegetation area. And then it's the rivers on the other side. And then just peeking through.
Yeah,
it's
you
a
can see it.
Ferris wheel.
Complete contrast to this pagoda. In case you couldn't tell where we are by now. over the bridge and into the city.
Oh yeah. Now it's where we get to the big tall buildings. My favorite
set. Yeah.
They don't look that tall.
Now that we're here.
They look pretty tall.
Trust
that. It says it's 100% legal and legit. Should we?
Do you regret not wearing a shirt?
A little bit. It was funny because this morning Lydia was like, oh yeah, like it'll probably be hot. And I'm like, nah, the weatherman says it'll be 25 degrees Celsius max.
And we then woke as up we were, and it was cold and foggy.
It was
right?
9 degrees Celsius. And then as we drove into the city, it got to 23.5. So it's definitely a lot more than 25 right now. But we just walked through the city and walked past the town hall, which is apparently the biggest town hall in Australia. And the city gives a very similar vibe to a lot of the other cities. I feel like the cities in Australia are all about getting the business done and about eating food.
I find a lot of the Australian cities have done it really well to where everything's segmented.
Yeah.
I find you're in the business area and it's all business people rushing about in suits.
Yeah.
And then you go into a shopping area, it's people chilling, it's shopping, but and then you easily come off into these green spaces and feel like you're not in a city at all.
Yeah.
I feel like the whole of Australia
it's all
has captured
done with
that
like a
really
purpose
well.
And yeah, you have the different crowds in the different areas.
Yeah, so we're in the, do we say we're in the Botanic Garden?
Yeah,
right
we're
now?
In the Botanic Garden. We've checked out every single botanical garden,
every single video.
In every city.
And they're always one of the most beautiful spots in the city.
Yeah.
But I think we're going to walk through it and start heading back to the ferry.
Yep.
Because we got to keep heading north.
Oh, yeah. Which is another thing. Like, if you have a look at things to do in Brisbane, a lot of people say, and I guess it goes for the whole of Australia, Australia is a lot of natural beauty.
Yeah.
And a lot of the things to do for Brisbane is outside of the CBD.
Yeah, I was looking at locals' recommendations online. They were all saying, head to Gold Coast, head to Sunshine. And obviously we love the Gold Coast, so I'm super pumped to get to Sunshine. I know it's nothing new, but it's so good to see you. Thank you. And I'm still so amazed by you. Thank you. Home sweet home. Oh. We are back in the van. And Chef, what are you whipping up?
We've got a loaf of bread that we need to eat. But also, if we're in the most multicultural city of Australia, I think it's only fitting that we have the most multicultural meal that I can possibly
eat. Oh, stop.
Which is butter chicken with garlic bread.
So basically, we have butter chicken that needs eating, but Vian is craving garlic bread.
I mean,
so he's trying to combine the two.
Yeah.
We're still parked along Brunswick Street. It seemed fine, doesn't seem like there's any issues. There's actually quite a few other campers here, interestingly. But we were really hungry, so we thought it would be fine to just cook up some food here before we get back on the road.
Oh my 10 gosh. Out of 10 for dishing, eh?
It looks like beans on toast.
I also ended up adding mushrooms because we have some mushrooms that are probably going to go off soon. So yeah, it's very, very
it's
mixed.
It's a mishmash butter chicken. Thank you.
Well, we went bananas over the last big thing that we saw, so we thought that we should keep it to the theme and try make a fruit salad. It's a big strawberry.
That was so bad.
It's sorry if you made this big strawberry, but it's like the complete polar opposite to the big banana. The big banana was very well done.
It needs like the leaves.
It has no dimension to it. I feel like the seeds have to like poke out a little bit. and like it's too perfect for a strawberry. It's like a cone. Like, you know the spin tops? Like as a kid, do you...
Well, now that Vian's seen about 10 big things, he thinks he's a professional.
I am a professional.
But this one did have very bad reviews.
It did.
And it feels like we're on someone's property. It feels like we shouldn't be here.
Mm.
But big strawberry. At least we've seen it.
Yep. Should we continue?
Yeah.
So we thought that we needed to elevate things a little bit in this video. So we've come out to the glass house lookout.
You said that's a weird glass.
Glass.
So fancy.
Yeah, I read the sign just then that said that it was named because the peaks look like the glass furnaces, so the glass houses.
Oh, really?
Back in the day, which is then. I might be wrong or misinterpreted that, but I'm 90% sure.
Very cool.
Yeah, I mean, it makes sense. They do just all of a sudden just
appear.
Yeah, it's pretty cool.
Of course we couldn't drive all this way with at least looking at the mountains via a lookout.
Yeah.
I feel like these are so iconic and they really do just...
They just pop out of nowhere.
...erupt out the ground. Like, we haven't seen mountains like this on the whole island.
No. Definitely unique.
They're so unique.
That almost looks like Castle Rock, but like a huge version of it.
Yeah.
Like it almost looks like the... it looks like the granite... thingies, rocks that just appear
out
of nowhere.
Yeah. But when we fully explore the Sunshine Coast, then we'll actually go hike one.
Yeah.
But we couldn't end this day without actually at least coming and having a look.
Yeah.
Campsite?
Yeah, campsite.
Before it gets dark. I don't want to drive in the dark. There's lots of kangaroo signs here.
Kangaroo signs.